Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to our rebuild of Jurassic Park right here in Jurassic World Evolution. In today's video, we are actually near the end of the tour. We only have two exhibits left to do. And today we're going to do the Triceratops slash Metriacanthosaurus. We don't really know what that exhibit's going to look like, so we're just going to make something up a little bit. But this one right here is going to be the one that's based on the film. Big Triceratops paddock here. Triceratops knocked out, lying on the ground down here. We'll do that towards the end when we do our film recreation bit. And so we're going to get some film screenshots and stuff like that and try to base this off the film. In the last video, we did the Tyrannosaurus Rex paddock, and I want to show you what I've done over there. So the main comment about the T-Rex paddock, those two, one was justifying the moat kind of thing. I understand what it's meant to be in the film, but no matter which way you look about it, the paddock doesn't necessarily make sense. I understand that there are references to moats and dams and stuff like that in the book, and I've read the book like 55 times at this point in time. But we know it's not totally consistently, internally consistent, and that's totally okay. But the main comment really was about this fence right here. Now, obviously, this fence is not there in the film. The reason I put the fence in, just like we did when we did this last time, is because this is meant to be a steep drop-off into, like, a forest, right? That's what this is meant to represent. And if you have the Rex able to just wander down there, then it kind of ruins the illusion. You know, in the film, I guess the idea is that they assume that Rexy isn't about to hurl herself off a cliff and commit suicide. We don't have a Rex like that. Our Rex will commit suicide. She will just wander down into the pit if we don't block her off. So that's why I put the fence in. But I had a little thought just a couple of minutes ago, just before I was about to record this video, to do this instead. Now, you remember I did a video the other week where we can use lights like this. I might have to neaten it up a little bit, but lights like this to restrict the movement of dinosaurs. This will actually work to stop the Tyrannosaurus Rex moving. I'm just going to... I want to clear out some tree bush stuff. Won't go away. Why won't it go away? That will actually stop the Rex moving. So what we can do is kind of represent the drop-off, stop the Rex moving in there, and not have to use those big bulky fences. Yes, the lights are, especially at night time, it's going to look a little bit odd, but I still think it's probably the best compromise we're going to be able to make. I think it's going to look pretty cool. And at night it's going to look baller, and it kind of looks like, you know, little concrete pointy bits sticking up, kind of like you'd have at the edge of a moat or something like that. So I'm pretty happy with this as a compromise. I'm not going to do it in this video just because it'll take a while, but before the next video or before the end, I will replace the entirety of that fence right there with the lights. That's the idea. Anyway, I've opened up the Rex exhibit a little bit because at the end of the day, from this side, you can't see anything anyway, which is what I really want, because the Rex does emerge from the forest. But there's no reason we can't have this area at the back a little bit more open and able to spot the Rex whenever she decides to wander into view, like she is right now. Anyways, today, Triceratops. I've actually already made one. I've got one sitting in there ready to go, but we're going to build a little bit of the exhibit first. Hopefully today you should be able to see the images and stuff that I bring in. Apologies for that in the last video. It's just because basically my recording program has two different modes, well, like four different modes, but it's got game recording, which will just record your game program by, like, just latching onto it, and also screen recording. I typically use screen, but last time I ended up using game, so it didn't pick up the images that I was dragging across, basically. But today that will not be a problem, as I shall show you. Bah! So that's kind of the image from the road as they view into the Triceratops paddock. My own copy of Jurassic Park, so I can kind of see the image of what it looks like as they're walking down the hill. So, I need to think about this. We're going to have them come out from this way. We've got this little river here, which you don't see in the film, and you're not really going to see here, but it is there on the maps and stuff like that. So we're going to use this bit here, because then we can kind of ignore that over there in the corner. Now, the interesting thing is they walk down a little bit. They do, you know, there's movement downwards. So I'm just going to, not over the top, because it will, well, won't work with the river, but I think flattening this into a slightly lower level is going to help us recreate that a little bit. So we'll just do, like, I don't know, again, I'm not really that worried about the river. They get out of the car along here and they go down the hill. Is that deep enough? I think we're just going to smooth it out. We're not going to be able to get it. You know, it's actually quite a steep little hill that they walk down. It's quite short but quite steep. Short but steep, does that make sense? Yeah, it's like, it doesn't go on for long, but it's quite a sharp drop that they walk down. But at least now they are walking downhill somewhat. That's kind of the important thing that I want to recreate there. We can get it nice and smooth, baby, nice and smooth. And if we do this, it means the river will look a little less daft as well. Which is nice. I feel bad for the river. I love this. Every now and again, I just see a nice multiple goats poking their head out that way. Alright, so we'll go for that. At least it's now, yeah, there's a noticeable dip there. Which is cool. Now, they walk down, basically straight from the car. And they go down like a dirt path. So we're going to dirty this up. I'm going to move it a little bit to the right. I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to bring across my plex. So they're walking down. There's the cars there. They're stopped. They're walking down. You can see this dirt path here. It's foliage and stuff to the sides. There's a hill behind them. And then the trike is in front of them in sort of the longer grass. And then beyond the trike is a big hill sort of shebang. So the trike would sit... I don't want the dirt to go all the way. The idea for the dirt, I think, is it's meant to represent this, how they, you know, I can't remember what it's called. There's a name for it, for trails that are created just because people happen to follow those paths all the time. I do know the word, I'm just completely blanking on it right now. So I'm going to make this whole area a little dirty, just because so that blends in a little bit and looks a little deft. And, you know, the trike could have been wandering around, stomping on the ground, muddying it up, eating food, blah, 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 blah. So that's the... It's a something trail. Ah, it's going to bug the bejeebus out of me, I tell you. I'm just going to dirty this up a little bit. So I don't want it to be too... Like, it makes sense that the trail is there, but it shouldn't be quite so neat and tidy. That's a little bit better. A trike would be sitting around here. So what we need is a little bit... It's actually not too dense on the forest. We need some forest here. I'll put some over there. And we need forest here. Kind of like to the side. And then the bit right next to the trail. I mean, there's a tree or two. We'll put one tree in. I've got severe hiccups all of a sudden. The cars are coming across that way. They hop out. They're coming down from there. The tree is there. There's a tree right there. So we're going to put that in as well. Which one are we going to use? Let's use that one. That sits about there. But by and large, there aren't many trees right next to the path. They're kind of spread out a little bit more. But there is a lot of foliage next to the path. And this is why I want bushes, by the way. This is like the perfect time for some, you know, slightly bigger plant life in this kind of area would be really cool. But not quite yet. I'm going to mix this up a little bit. It's quite dirty looking stuff. You know, it's a lot of heavy looking stuff. It's a lot of browns and greys. So I think using the crag to represent that is a good idea. Even a little bit. Oh, see, that's a problem. So they'll be walking down from there. I'll show you what this is. So this is the hill. The hill's maybe a little bit softer than I would have liked. But if you look at that there, compared to that, you'll see it's pretty close. The hill's definitely... I think we can steepen the hill up a little bit. But I can't really do much about the lack of coverage, about the lack of plant coverage. But we're definitely going to... Yeah, let's make this hill... steeper. It doesn't even have to be the whole thing. It can just be like a little thing there, because you don't really see down there. Actually, you do a little bit, but we're going to end up covering that with stuff anyway. Smooth it out. I want the height and the depth and the hill, but I don't want it to look hilly. Does that make sense? Probably not. Get my contour lines on the go. I love myself a contour line. I really do. Get that nice and smooth. That's better, yeah. It's still not as sharp as it is in the film, but that's definitely an improvement. Good stuff. Right, so now we need to do... If I bring this across. So that's what they end up looking at. So you can see at the back, we've got this tall hill, which we'll build as well as we can. And then we'll cover that with plant life. And there's just lots of heavy grasses again, which we can't really do. You don't really see off to the sides, but I think it's fairly open all the way across when in there. So that's, say the trike is around there. We can try to build a hill. What we can do is actually block off the back half of the exhibit a little bit with a hill. What's in here? What's this? See, that's the T-Rex exhibit, but it's not necessarily a part that we care about, if that makes sense. See, already I'm running out of room here. kind of want it to just go across here. Is that nuts? I think that's a good idea. Low health? What's low health? Oh, you don't have any food. wait, why aren't you meeting the goats? There's a goat right there. What do you need? Do you need food? Alright, I'm going to give you a meat feeder. Don't know why you're not eating the goat. I did turn combat back on, didn't I? Didn't I? No, I didn't. That would be why. The big whoops. Okay. Let's just fix things. Yeah, so this is a little closer than I'd like it, but if we want the hill to go straight across, like it does in the film, then we need it to be close up. I'm going to smooth that out a little bit more. This is the problem with trying to combine film and maps and stuff like that. You end up in a situation like this, but that's pretty good anyway. We're going to cover this. This is quite heavily dense with trees, and I know the fence is bad, but the idea, hopefully, is to put so many trees here they don't really see the fence anyway. And then we'll keep that like that. And it kind of hides the way that the hill less than perfectly blends into the environment, you know? I don't think that's far off. I actually think that's pretty good. I'd like more trees. Because when do I not? But if I can block off the hill more than we are, that would be great. I just don't want to see the fence. All I hear is screaming velociraptors. That should be enough, right? Yeah, look at that. Beautiful. Got a nice... Yeah, no, that's good stuff. Okay. Right. So, second problem is that I want to bring... Or, like, 20th problem is that I want to bring some grassland into here. But it will ruin... I think we have to go for it. I kind of liked the dirty look, but I think we need... the grass to kind of represent the exhibit more. Maybe I'll just kind of do it like that, you know, leaving some patches of dirt in there a little bit. And we'll do the same with our crag. Greg. The crag's... Why are you moving suspiciously? You, little tree. I'm a little elephant-looking plant. I'm very suspicious of you. Just know that I'm watching you, buddy boy. Always watching you, because I have very little else to do with my time. And all this is nothing. We can do whatever we want over there. Okay. It's not bad. It's dense. We've got the hill at the back. We have the trees. We've got the slope going in. There is, I believe, a fence post. I don't know what this is. We're gonna put this to a vote again. There's a this here. I think this actually is a fence post. What we can do, but it looks like a wooden fence. I can't watch the film. If I play the film, I'll get slapped for copyrights. We're gonna leave that for now. What I will do is replay it at some point and double check that. I just don't want to get... YouTube's very angry these days, you know. I don't really want to get in trouble. Alright, let's get some trees around here. Ah, right, yeah, the back of the exhibit. The back of the exhibit is actually a hill. Now, it's actually kind of perfect. I know we've got another exhibit here that you don't see in the film. There's really nothing we can do about that. The Metricamosaurus isn't there in the film, even if it's there on the maps. But behind the exhibit is... As you can see, it's like a dirt hill and then there's sort of trees on the top and there's trees dotted along it. So what we'll do is we'll paint this hill in dirt. Dirty, dirty dirt. And we'll just dot some trees in the area. It's quite hard with the hills to do sometimes just because of the contour lines. They're very intense. Can I put these trees on there? Or is it going to flatten? Yeah. Ah, that's okay anyway. Okay, so there's our dirty hill behind the Triceratops exhibit. I think we're pretty good. We've got this whole mess over here that we can do anything with. We're going to hide the feeder over here. I don't want the feeder to be spotted in public. What we will do eventually is move it over there. When the trike gets there, we're going to tranquilize it and hopefully have a sleeping Triceratops in the middle of the exhibit. We can't do that right now because it'll... die, but we can do that, you know, when we do our film scene recreations properly towards the end of the playthrough. So again, let's bring some trees. This should be actually quite a tree-ish area. It's an official term, don't look it up. Don't want to go too overboard, but this next exhibit is the Dilophosaurus exhibit, and I think what we're gonna do is base it a little bit on the Nedry's I don't want to call it Nedry's Killers because I always do, but we're going to base it a little bit on that scene. You know, we're going to have the hill and drops down into the water and dirt and the trees and the forest. So it's good to have some forest in the area, kind of to make the blending in process a little bit smoother, something like that. Okay, right. Let's get our Triceratops sent in, and then we'll do our Metricomposaurus, and then we're done. I did debate whether this was the right skin to use. Very briefly. I realized my debate was stupid, and I'll explain why. But there isn't another skin at all that I think better represents the original Triceratops. Because at the end of the day, it's based on the original Triceratops. Now, my problem with this skin is I think it is. This isn't really a problem per se, but the reason I was considering another skin is because this Triceratops skin, although based on the basic original Triceratops skin, is still too brown. It should be bluer. The basal model used for the Triceratops it's actually a rather deep but vivid blue. It's very noticeably blue. This one has kind of shades of it underneath the dirt, but it's definitely a lot browner than the actual model was. However, because we're doing this based on the film anyway, and the one in the film is lying in the dirt and is covered in dirt, and that's why everyone thinks it's brown in the first place, this one's actually kind of perfect. So, not a problem, basically. Don't know why I had to tell you that story, but I did. Metricamphosaurus. We don't really. Wait, I'm gonna see if we can. I actually forgot to do this research, and I apologize. Metriacanthosaurus Jurassic Park. You can hear my professional YouTubing. Did it ever get into the park? Nope. 71% genome completion. So I guess we just use the default one? Yeah. I think we're gonna do two. Just because, other than the Rex, like even the Baryonyx had five of them, you know. I don't think they'd ever have a dinosaur other than the Rex that didn't have more than one dinosaur. You know, Rex is the only dinosaur in the whole thing that only has one version, only has one sample. And even that's only on Isla Nublar. You go over to Isla Sorna, and there's three of the bloody things, if you include the babies, so. Well, I'm sure the baby wasn't planned, but the point is there's three, or at the minimum two. Actually, there's four. If you include the baby, because there's also the Rex from Jurassic Park 3, which I do not believe is any of the Rexes from the Lost World. I know there's like little fan theories about that, but I don't think so. So there's at least four Rexes on Sorna. Anyways, well, three now. I guess one's dead. Moving on. So little Metricomposaurus exhibit. Don't really know what we're gonna do with this one. Give them a go, I guess. Probably give them a little bit of. What we can do, I don't really want to ruin the shape of the rivers and stuff like that, so we'll just extend it out just so it's more clearly inside the exhibit, you know, and they can go over there for a snack. There's a service road at the back, so I don't want to block that off. Let's keep this relatively open. Maybe I can use a fancy tree and some rocks. I can use rocks. There's one benefit to using these little the exhibits you don't see in the film. Again, with the I can't help it. It's such a bad habit though. We can use rocks. Actually, one reason we want to keep this clear is because actually, yeah, we're gonna keep this super clear. Because that's gonna we're gonna have sort of trees on the side, but this middle bit I want clear because that's gonna match more what we see in the film with the dirty hill and stuff like that. There just happens to be some like it's a little bit of a longer gap, and there happens to be a goat, and eventually some Metricomposauruses. But by and large, it shouldn't be a big deal. It's definitely closer to the film. I'm just gonna do some stuff on the ground. Make it look a little bit more interesting. And crag. We're in a craggy sort of area, so let's stick with that. That makes more sense. A little bit of grassland as well. Ah, it's not grassland. There we go. That'll do. Right, Metricomposaurus, done. So what we do also need is our signs. I think you'd have the Triceratops first, because it's open on the left to the Triceratops. You never see this sign, but you know, we want it in the game. Did I do the Rex sign? I did. It's by the bathroom. So let's stick that about there. It's a shame about the shadow direction. It really is. And then we want our medium carnivore one. I know. People said this is meant to be. Is that meant to be Baryonyx? I'm pretty sure that's Spinosaurus, right? Am I crazy? Someone said that was meant to be Baryonyx and that actually used large carnivore, but I'm pretty sure Baryonyx is a medium carnivore. Is there a Spinosaurus one? No, there isn't. I don't know, that looks... I mean, that is the Metricamosaurus, so that's actually... Is that the Metricamosaurus? I think that's the Metricamosaurus. So that's actually perfect. We'll put that... there. That, to me, looks like the Spinosaurus. But I'm like, oh, no, it doesn't. It looks like the Baryonyx. Was it the Suchomimus? It actually looks more like the Suchomimus to me. I actually have no idea which one that's meant to be. Maybe it is the Baryonyx, but... still, the medium carnivore one suits more, in my opinion. Because at the end of the day, I think it's a medium carnivore, so... And I think the Suchomimus is a large carnivore. I'm putting my bets on the Suchomimus, but I really don't know. Although it does have knobbly bits on its head, which makes me think it's the Barry. It could be any. You could be well right. Don't leave it alone. What are you panicking about? I'm not sure this is a good idea. Right, okay. Once these Metries are across, which they should be ready, and they certainly are, we are actually done. Nice snappy little episode, folks. Snappy, snappy, snap. What else do we have to do? Well, we have to get rid of all this eventually. This bit in the middle. I'm going to keep the concrete tour, the concrete roads, but only for the bits outside of the paddock. I want to do something with the docks. I'm not really sure what yet. I want to make them look like docks, if at all possible. The docks should be around here somewhere. I like this a little bit. I don't know what else. Obviously, the visitor center needs clearing up a little bit, but it's not bad. It's nearly there already. We just need to... Oh, we need a big-ass hill is what we need. What about big-ass hill? Oh, God, radius, you're so small. I just want to build a volcano. I think the best way to do this is to do that and flatten. Yeah, there we go. That's what we're looking for. Beautiful stuff. Big-ass hill. Big-ass hill. It's really just meant to represent Mount Sibo, which is present on one of the Isla Nublars, but is not present on this one. No. Didn't think I was going nuts, but you never really know, folks. You really don't. So we'll do that again. Let's get this nice and high, nice and pointy. That's how we like it. Elbows too pointy. Come on, up you pop. All right, hop back to there in a second. I want to get these Metries sorted. It's coming together really well. Oddly enough. I'm still waiting for something. Like, I've had to do the track about 50 billion different times, so I'm waiting for something to go wrong, but it's working so far. It is. This looks bizarre. This looks like someone's poking themselves through a donut. What they're poking through the donut, I'll leave up to your imagination, but it looks like they're poking through a donut. I want a donut. Up we come. Up we come. I mean, it's not going to look like Mount Sibo, but it'll look like a mountain, sort of. If I keep flattening, it should in theory work. All the way up to the top. Asset transportation underway. There we go, because I can't flatten over here, really. Any sort of camp. That's cool. That actually looks pretty cool anyway. I just wish it wasn't so pointy, like that way. Maybe I can flatten that. There you go. It's a mountain. It's a Mount Sibo. Just roll with me on this one. If we then kind of like surround the base with forest. It needs a trim is what it bloody needs. And we'll add some dirt and rock on there as well. Especially at the top. The higher reaches should be more rocky than the lower reaches. There may be more dirt around the middle. Kind of like the grass is fading out into dirt and rock. And some trees. Not all the way up, but just so it looks less like it's, you know, really awkwardly rings like it looks right now. I don't really like how that looks. The rock looks a little bit odd. I want to lighten that up. There we go, mountain. Cool. Right, so mountain done. Metricamosaurus is on the way, except this one over here. And we are basically done for today. So, spend a little time. Where's our tricap? Having a munch. I need to do my new revised dinosaur tier list. I keep talking about this, but I keep forgetting to do it. The Triceratops and the T-Rex and the Velociraptors. I love them all so much, and they need to be rewarded for their new I did not like the old Triceratops, but Triceratops is my favorite dinosaur, so the new Triceratops deserves lots and lots and lots of love. I love you so much. Do you know that? I do. You, I love lots and lots and lots. Or you watching this video. It's up to you. Right. Yeah. That's good, isn't it? Sexy. What are we doing? Where's our raptors? I want to check the raptors out just because they're cool. And they are cool. I want to see if the big one is still alpha. No, see, we have to change that. It changes. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. God, I can't spell. I think there's still two alphas, yeah. Four and six are both alphas. It's gonna shift a lot. It's now two and... you know, it's changed again. Four and six just got demoted. Or, wait, was it four that I made the rat? Yeah, six got demoted. And now two is the alpha instead. So, it's gonna go back and forth a lot. Oh, well. Looking good. Bazza, how you doing, Bazza? It's quite cool, man. I really do like that you can turn off these social limits, because having a few of them roaming together, because they do form groups, sort of, it's just they never get the opportunity because their social need limits that, but when you get a few of them together, it actually looks pretty awesome. And I don't like the Baryonyxes. Did they fix the... Someone said they fixed the pinkness. Is that a mod that does that? It looks less pink. Have they fixed it? The Baryonyxes always had like really weird pink splodges around the mouth. Maybe they've changed that. That'd be cool. I'm confused. Oh, it's there. I'm easily confused. Where's the other one? Wait, now I am confused. If I put the Metricanthosaurus somewhere, I assume... Oh, it's there. Never mind. How you doing, buddy? Very cool. Right. Ladles and gentle spoons, we are going to end things there. Next video, the Dilophosaurus habitat for the second time. Again, We don't really see this one in the film. Like, we're living on the assumption that the one we see in the film is this one. This is the one that looks like the one from the film. That's why there's no Dilophosaurus in it. This one will have Dilophosaurus. And we may as well make it look like the Nedry bit, just because that's a cool little nod. And this is not a paddock we have any information on anyway, so we may as well make it cool. I don't think we do. I'll do some research just in case, as I tend to do anyway, but... I will make sure. I want this... Again, foresty. Come on. I'll do. Right, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks in the next video. Thank you again for all the comments and stuff like that. I know some people still think we should be using the Troodon for the Cerchisaurus instead of the Compsognathus. I can definitely see that based on their real life sizes. I'm not totally sure that the evolution sizes correspond to that in the same way, if that makes sense. But I'm still thinking and discussing that. But if you have any other comments or suggestions, stuff like that, I am all ears. Not literally, because that'd be goddamn terrifying. Thanks for joining me. Remember to hit the like button. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye. Hey, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.